So, continuing on with the recap, this is another comment that I received from N7Normandy1. Yeah, so thanks again for posting a lot of comments on my videos. And he posted a comment on my video, Prisoners in Jail, Posting Videos on Facebook, which is a video response of that same video title made by How the World Works, Lee Doran, I think that's the YouTuber that made that video, and I made the bridging response. And this is a comment that N7Normandy1 made. It's hard. Some prisoners get angrier being in prison, and more frustration and guilt probably builds inside them. So when they leave, and they did a good job hiding it, then someone could get killed again. I think it really depends on the person. There are some who appear to be really pleasant people, and they say they know they are a danger, not to other people, but to themselves, and want to stay in prison. A lot of interesting thoughts there. I don't really know how to comment or respond to that. So I don't think I actually responded to this particular comment, but we did have a great kind of a discussion on that video, a YouTube discussion there about that. So definitely, thanks for the comment. Next comment comes from, on the same video, the YouTube user, No More Than Most, and this is what the person says. A little knowledge is a dangerous thing. You don't know shit about prison, what it's like, or how it works. So I found that very funny because I actually totally admit that in the video itself. Moving on. Next comment comes from Nick421. Actually, I went to prison for simple possession of marijuana. My bunkmate was convicted of manslaughter for stabbing a man in the bar. They don't segregate prisoners based on crime. Don't believe that. And that's why American prison is so insane. That's the comment. And I would respond, yeah, among many other reasons, that definitely is a problematic thing in the American justice system, that people who are convicted of nonviolent, non-serious crimes, which I personally don't even think should be considered a crime, like possession of marijuana, end up in prison, and in that prison they're put in the same bunk or same cell, same prison building as someone who is convicted of a serious violent crime like manslaughter, like first degree murder, or rape or things of that nature. So criminals, people who are convicted of violent crimes are put in the same prison as people who are convicted of nonviolent crimes. And personally, I don't think they should even be crimes, but that's a different topic altogether. That's a different topic altogether, but yeah, it's very problematic. But in the video, I was just kind of wanting to bring up the notion that, you know, we do have in theory, in concept, different facilities for different crimes or severity of the crime. You know, we have maximum security prisons. We have, lower level security prisons. We have jails. We have bail houses. So, you know, there are different facilities which are for different severity of crimes. And that's really the point I wanted to make. But yeah, obviously, that doesn't always happen. In fact, it kind of seems to be rarely happening. The prison system is really, really problematic in so many, so many ways. But yeah, that's definitely one issue there. And yeah, thanks for sharing your comment and your experience. So, always awesome. That was a comment from Nick421. Next comment comes from N7Normandy1 on my video where I talk about my favorite characters from Mass Effect Trilogy. And I just wanted to highlight this video because I think this kind of summarizes N7Normandy1's thoughts on the videos. But he makes a lot of great comments on my videos, especially about Mass Effect. So definitely, if you like Mass Effect and want to hear my thoughts on it, check some of those videos out. He comments, Javik, Thane, Kaiden, Liara, and Shepard are at the top of my top favorite characters list in Mass Effect Trilogy. Kaiden was so much better in Mass Effect 3, I thought. But then again, I love the elusive man in Mass Effect 2 and 3. His last line in Mass Effect 3 was just so awesome and similar to Saren if he chose the Paragon. He puts the gun to his head and says, I tried, Shepard. And I also loved how in the end, the elusive man kind of needs Shepard to slap sense into him. So, really awesome comment, and yeah, totally. Like, the final moment where if you choose to go all Paragon route with the Elusive Man, and it kind of just makes Elusive Man regret all his past actions, such a powerful and awesome scene that is you can have on Mass Effect 3. So, pretty awesome. Thanks for the comment again. The next comment comes from is in the video I owe Citibank $105,000, which to my surprise is a video that's about, I don't know, 3 or 4 years old, but I look at, like, you know, my inbox and consistently it's getting consistent amount of comments and it's still getting consistent amount of views. I feel like it's getting, like, I don't know, it's a good amount of views, like 100 views every day, it seems like, or, you know, like 2,000 views every week. It's pretty amazing. Maybe not that much, but it's pretty amazing that video is still getting that amount of attention right now. It's considering how old this video is. I also get a very lot of interesting comments, some of which I consider to be pretty stupid, but I still find them pretty humorous. That video has some of the most interesting and ridiculous comments on there. I'm gonna highlight just two comments from the video that I received this week. One comment comes from Jack Melhoff. LOL, I was expecting you to say shitty bank with an Asian accent. Not racist, just thinking of South Park's City Walk. Or Chitty Walk. I don't really know how the Asian accent is supposed to say Citibank. I guess I'm supposed to say Chitty Bank? Something like that? Is that an Asian accent? Chitty Bank? But yeah, that's interesting comment. And of course, somebody else replied to that. Another YouTuber responded saying, you know, it was racist, and they have this, like, back and forth kind of conversation going on, if you're going to consider a conversation. But it's interesting there. Gonna leave it at that. And then the other comment comes from Lamia Kashin. I wonder if I'm saying his name right. The comment is, social workers don't get paid shit. Which I find to be pretty humorous. And generally speaking, it's kind of true. Most social workers do not get... Social work is not a very high-paying field if you're gonna compare it to other fields like law, medicine, nursing, computer engineering, business, you know, the entertainment industry and such. Yeah, I mean, it's not a very high-paying field, sure, but it depends on what type of social work you get into. Some social work fields you get into can be pretty high-paying. You can get paid up to, you know, ranging from $80,000 a year to $200,000, $300,000 a year with a social work path. Which usually isn't talked about a lot. I mean, I definitely won't talk about it a lot because that's not the kind of field I see myself going into, but it's definitely possible. And I replied to this comment saying, you know, hey, depending on which social work type you get into, you can get a high-paying job, like in the medical, you know, medical social workers, a researcher in a hospital or in a lab setting, and with the social work kind of orientation, you get paid quite a bit. The clinical route, therapist, psychologist, psychiatrist, counselor, having a private practice, pretty high paying. And also, of course, heads of nonprofits. CEO of a charity, a founder of a nonprofit organization, a policy analyst in a nonprofit think tank. Again, these are all kinds of ways where you can get really high up in the social work field. And yeah, generally speaking, compared to other fields, not as high paying, sure. You're not going to be making millions of dollars a year. If that's what you're expecting out of social work, it's not going to happen. But generally speaking, you can get into social work fields where it does pay fairly well. Very comfortable living income. But generally speaking, most social work fields are kind of low paying or adequate amount paying. But social workers, I feel like, don't get into it worried about getting paid a lot. That's not the drive, the passion of the social work field. But yeah, that's one of the comment. Lamia Kashin also responded back with a different comment to my response, which I didn't find as interesting as this one. So yeah, So that's the those are all the comments that I wanted to highlight that I received on my videos this week. Next week I will be uploading much more videos. Hopefully that's the plan. So I don't know what kind of comments I'll be getting. Getting comments is always something that like excites me. Like, oh my gosh, you know, I got a comment on my video. I wonder what's happening. And then I comment, and then there's sometimes it happens that this crazy stream of YouTube discussion there. It's always interesting to find great deal of comments. That's kind of what drives me to make these YouTube videos, to see these discussions happen. And also just to, you know, be narcissistic and throw my thoughts out there. So that those are the comments I received this week. All right, so now let's move on to actual topics now and move away from my YouTube channel and YouTube comments.